All right, well, I'm getting this time. I'll go ahead and turn me to Luke chapter 4. Luke chapter 4. And we're going to begin in verse 1. Let me just set my timer real quick. All right, Luke chapter 4. We're going to open up with a word of prayer real quick. Heavenly Father, thank you for this opportunity for me to stand up here and preach your word. I pray that you would just give me utterance, Lord God, and just help to convey what you would have me to preach, Lord, and just give me a clear mind and just help it to flow well. And we just love you and thank you for this opportunity to gather together. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Luke chapter 4, beginning in verse 1, the Bible reads, it says, "And Jesus, being full of the Holy Ghost, returned from Jordan and was led by the Spirit into the wilderness, being 40 days tempted of the devil. And in those days he didn't eat nothing. And when they were ended, he afterward hungered. And the devil said unto him, If thou be the Son of God, command this stone that it be made bread. And Jesus answered him, saying, It is written, that man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word of God. And the devil, taking him up into an high mountain, showed him all the kingdoms of the world in a moment of time. And the devil said unto him, All this power will I give thee, and the glory of them, for that is delivered unto me, and to whomsoever I will I give it. If thou therefore wilt worship me, all shall be thine. And Jesus answered and said unto him, Get thee behind me, Satan, for it is written, Thou shalt worship the Lord thy God, and him only shalt thou serve. The title of my sermon tonight is Get Thee Behind Me, Satan. Now, every man in this room has a God-ordained purpose. Obviously, the will of God is that we would believe on him and that we would be a workman and we would do works for God. And the Christian life is not an easy life. It takes discipline, sacrifice to do the will of God. And like I said, obviously we believe first, and then he has work for us to do. We need to provide for our family. It's hard work to be a good husband, a good father, to study his word, preach the gospel. All these things take hard work, and we're always constantly striving for perfection. And there are times in your life where you're going to have to say, Get thee behind me, Satan. And it can be to your friends. It could be to your foes. It could even be to yourself. Obviously, you know, I'm not the devil or anything like that. That's not what I'm saying. But I do want to give you two specific things that will hinder you from accomplishing God's will, and to where you would have to say, Get thee behind me, Satan. So in Luke chapter 4, it says in verse 8, And Jesus answered and said unto him, Get thee behind me, Satan, for it is written, Thou shalt worship the Lord thy God, and him only shalt thou serve. So Satan is constantly dangling things of this world in front of our eyes and attempting to take us away from the will of the Father. Riches, success, it could be even spending too much time with your friends. We're constantly being bombarded with the things of this world, and the Bible says that Satan is the god of this world. So we're constantly having to push back and be disciplined and to focus on the things of God. You know, while these things are inherently sinful, i.e. providing for your family, having recreation, you know, spending time with your family, obviously those things are inherently sinful, but when you start to become unbalanced, it can become sinful. Right? You can marry yourself to your job, and you can neglect your wife and your children. Or you can actually do the exact opposite, and you can, you know, have all this time with your family, and you're neglecting your job. You're not providing for your family. Or you're spending too much time doing one thing, and you're not, you know, involved with the things of God. You know, soul winning, going to church, what have it. And so the things of this world are constantly bombarding us to where we have to say, Get thee behind me, Satan. Right? So one of the things that I want to talk about or just demonstrate is the fact that, you know, the devil, right, is one of the easiest. Now, this is the easiest one to kind of, you know, hey, to stay away from, because, you know, the devil wants you to do the things that you're not supposed to do. And as long as we're in God's word, you know, we have the tools that we need to be able to push back against him. You know, Jesus right here, you know, he's being tempted. And he's able to say, Get thee behind me, Satan. But that's one that we all know of is the enemies of God, i.e. the devil, right? But another one that's more difficult is your friends. Turn with me real quick to Matthew chapter 16. Matthew chapter 16, starting in verse 21. Matthew chapter 16, verse 21, the Bible reads, From that time forth began Jesus to show unto his disciples how that he must go into Jerusalem, and suffer many things of the elders and chief priests and scribes, and be killed and be raised again the third day. Then Peter took him and began to rebuke him, saying, Be it far from thee, Lord, this shall not be unto thee. But he turned and said unto Peter, Get thee behind me, Satan. Thou art an offense unto me, for thou savorest not the things that be of God, but those that be of men. So Peter here, obviously, we know, was one of the main apostles. He's like one of Jesus' main guys. He's super zealous, but he's always kind of like getting into trouble. And Jesus here says to one of his best guys, the apostle Peter, Get thee behind me, Satan. Now, he's not Judas Iscariot. You know, Jesus obviously knew who he was from the beginning. You know, Peter is a great man of God, but here he is, and I don't think that he's trying to be a stumbling block unto the Lord. You know, he's trying to be zealous and he's trying to do the right thing, but God has to rebuke him. And what does he call Peter? This is a believer. This is someone who's trying to stand in the way of Jesus Christ, God in the flesh, accomplishing the mission that God has given him. And so he tells Peter, clear as day, Get thee behind me, Satan, right? So that's pretty interesting because obviously we know that, you know, the devil, that's, you know, a lot of people, we kind of forget that he said that to the apostle Peter. And so there will be times where you even have to tell your closest friends and family, Get thee behind me, Satan. Because anything that comes in between you and doing the will of the Father, the will that God has for you to do, right? You need to be able to push away from that. You need to be able to tell that person, you know, hey, just like Jesus said, know ye not, I must be about my Father's business. You know, he said that from the age of 12 when his mother and Joseph were searching after him. Like, why have you done this to us? And he's like, know ye not that I must be about my Father's business? He was always about his Father's business. And he was always, you know, the will of the Father was always on his mind. So Luke chapter 4, go with me real quick to Luke chapter 4. It's Luke chapter 4, starting in verse 40, Luke chapter 4, verse 40. I'm going to blow through this real quick. Now when the sun was setting, all they that had any sick with divers diseases brought them unto him, and he laid his hands on every one of them and healed them. And devils also came out of the many, crying out and saying, Thou art Christ, the Son of God. And he rebuking them, suffered them not to speak. For they knew that he was Christ. And when it was day, he departed and went into a desert place, and the people sought him and came unto him and stayed him, that he should not depart from them. And he said unto them, I must preach the kingdom of God to other cities also, for therefore am I sent. And he preached in the synagogues of Galilee. So here you go, Jesus is, he's doing all these miracles, and the people are trying to keep him back from doing what he needed to do, go out into the other cities and preach the gospel. And so Jesus is having to tell them, hey, these are people that are very fond of him. They're seeing all his miracles, and he's having to tell them, hey, I can't stay. I can't hang around, all right? I have work to do. You know, so these are friends. These are people that are very, you know, they admire the Lord, but he's about his Father's business, you know? So he said it to the devil. He said it to the Apostle Peter, and those are the two main instances, but I want to give you something, some bonus real quick, and that is, obviously, like I said, you know, foe and friend, but you also have to be leery of yourself, okay? Be leery of yourself, because, you know, just as Jesus, turn me to Luke chapter 22 real quick. Turn me to Luke chapter 22. We're going to look at Jesus real quick in the Garden of Gethsemane, and I want to look at this perfect example, you know, of God in the flesh being our perfect example. Luke chapter 22, verse 39, the Bible reads, And he came out and went, as he was wont, to the Mount of Olives, and his disciples also followed him. And when he was at the place, he said unto them, Pray that ye enter not into temptation. And he was withdrawn from them about a stone's cast, and kneeled down and prayed, saying, Father, if thou be willing, remove this cup from me. Here's the key. Nevertheless, not my will, but thine be done. And I think it's amazing that you see, you know, Jesus Christ speaking to the Father, and he's telling him, he's like, you know, as a man, God as a man, he's saying, not my will, but thine be done. And that's an amazing thing, because he's able to push back from the devil, and he's able to push back to the people that want to keep him from doing what God has commanded him to do, but he has that will of the flesh, and he's able to suppress that. Now, obviously, we're always going to fall short of that, because we're not God. You know, Jesus Christ was the perfect man. He was God in the flesh. But that's an amazing thing that we should always keep in our mind, is Jesus saying, not my will, but thine be done. And we should always be seeking after the will of the Father. So I'm going to leave you with this. Luke chapter 9, verse 23. The Bible says, And he said to them all, If any man will come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross daily and follow me. Let's bow our heads and have a word of prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, I thank you for this opportunity to preach once again. I pray that I was able to convey that well, Lord God, and that it would just help all the men in this service and the children. And I would just hope that all these things are done to glorify you. And we ask these things in Jesus' name. Amen.